try to do some more of these side quests. Some of the side quests actually carry over from the old game. I mean, you don't have to redo them again. And I'm assuming it's the ones that give you rewards that are kind of account bound, I guess we want to call it that. For instance, the little sister looking for the big sister's replaceable part. After you do that, you get a ribbon. Then when you talk back, pretty much you turn it back to the older sister, she gives you a ribbon herself. And so you get two ribbons. And those carry over into the new playthrough. Show you in a second. So here in the key items, we get these two ribbons. He looks so funny with it. It was like, I don't know, it doesn't suit him, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Just that color. I don't know. Just doesn't suit him.
Material obtained.
This guy is still alive. I think after this playthrough of it, especially if the story stays exactly the same, just from 9S's perspective, I might go ahead and just research and look up what the other kind of criteria is to get the other endings. I feel like it's pretty much. Oh yeah. Kung Fu Man. I feel like some of these choices that you make pretty much dictate what you will get. Say, you know, after you get to the boss fight, okay, it's gonna glitch you right there. But once you get to the part where you kill the girl who's trying to be beautiful, right? Or the female robot who's trying to be beautiful. They say that was like a evil machine or something like that. And then they pretty much take you to their safe haven. Pascal's hidden village. You have the option of saying no, but maybe it's either the force option, or that's one of the options that you can choose to kind of change the path of the story. Thank you. You gotta just leave the platform and then come back and he's ready to fight again. Or not, no, no. I might have to wait for the storyline to progress a little bit. Okay, so I guess I can go to these other storyline quests. It's like way in the desert. I would like to get the waypoints, but I think we lose the capability of doing certain things once we unlock the waypoints. So I don't want to do that. So let's go ahead and find my way all the way out there. Let's see how I get there. I should do the desert. I saw like another color. I don't know. So there's like a orangey color to the damage numbers. And that might be 2B's damage output, which is definitely high. She did like 2k in one hit. This is like the way back from when we escaped. Yes, I think it is. Don't know if it's the right way, but I'm gonna go ahead and take it. See how far it leads me. Seems to be taking me to the right spot, so let's keep going. Very bright sun. So let's see who these two enemies are. Just a generic one.
Thank you.
matter. Machine's over there. Talk to you. That's a crafting material. Hello. White machine. Who are you? Machine getting love. You came here from Master Jean Paul's village, didn't you? I can tell you. I can smell it on you. Jeez. Okay, that's weird. Jean Paul's wonderful. He pursues his new knowledge with a passion that is almost indescribable. I admire him as I do not do no other. You have issues, and you clearly lack a discerning eye. I bet men take advantage of you all the time. Like, nope, can't do that. She cut you up. What sucks too is I have to go back to Jean Paul, and I think I have to come back here to turn it in. Maybe we can go all the way back to the main entrance of it. I'm pretty sure I ran diagonally this way, so yeah. On the way up this hill. Should be able to go back from the main way, right? Might be there? Yep. Project Gestalt Report. I feel like I can't get up this way. I'll try. Oh, I can. I feel like I should at least research where to grind to get some of the parts. let me know. Keep following it. Oh, there's also a push right there, actually. Over there. There's a box. Nowhere. I don't think I've done this quest at all yet, so it's interesting to see what it is. Definitely a lot of these side quests are meant for us to kind of get into the heads of these machines. Oh, it's not even a side quest, it's just a robot.
Commencing fishing.
So far, I think fishing is just for selling. I don't really see no reason to keep the fish.
Hypothesis. Garbage.
Garbage. Garbage. Battery tank. So it's not quite garbage, it's still something. It's just not fish. Tibby's like, what is all of this? That was a little actually.
Report. Ooh. Unknown object.
Oil sergeant.
No response. Unknown object. Complete.
Oh, the water shallow. Still not even fishing.
Yeah.
fast travel locations unlocked right now. Have to wait till pretty much halfway through the game. Just gonna at least the story. Except you fight the Goliath in the main city, and that opens up the possibility of unlocking waypoints. This is a very expansive desert too. I really hope I don't have to come back here to turn the John Paul quest in. There's a hack box in this area. Assuming level 99 is the highest level in this game. I also wonder if turning it on higher follow the waymarkers. Stretched coil. This seems to be uncommon. I don't really should get those. It seems that's the way up. I think I saw a box up there. Actually. This pipe to climb up there. Yep. Thousand gems. So yeah, she had a pretty long, can't say long quest line, but a lot of battle quest line. They had to fight like three separate waves of enemies. Oh, this guy's ready actually. Can handle all this awesomeness. Yeah. Alright. Oh, he's taller. He's a tail. He's a battle suit. Yep. Gonna mess you up. Silver ore, pristine screw, and a broken battery. I know you're not broken.
Target location data obtained. Marking on map.
Do you already have it? Nope. Pristine screw, probably. Oh, black belt. Something over here. Where's this forest zone? Can I get there right now? I don't know if I can actually. So let's get this pristine screw, or whatever this is. Thank you. like he has a spare part.
Requested material obtained.
That's all of it. That's it. Just one of many. Because of you. Stevie. Surrender the items. Thank you, my child. Nice, nice, nice. Where to go now? Alright, Pascal's place. Let's go to Pascal's place. Time to turn in all these quests. At least continue a lot of them. I think I don't mind a quest like that where they're bunched up, so I just complete them all in the same area instead of like making it a fetch. It here, but then go over there to do it, and come back. It's very time consuming, necessarily. Oh, he's already ready to go. Alright then, let's whip your behind. Oh geez, he's a big guy now. Not like that matters. Turn to a full-size battle bot. Big, Mr. Father. Taste of a forbidden foods. Oh, actually get the message. So pity. Gold. Still more? Jeez.
Target location data obtained. Marking on map.
This is close. This guy just keeps getting stronger and stronger, but so do I. Okay, so do we. Without 2B here, I don't even know if I'll be able to beat him that quickly. Then again, I'm hacking, so it makes it a lot easier. Let's see. I think I can get up there from here. That's all I need. Nearby, sort of. It's behind the resistance camp, I think. No, it's in the flooded city. Okay, so I can't do that till after. Or maybe I can get there. I don't know. Let's actually go here. I think that's that one girl by the gate.
Commencing fishing.
Let's try it. Oh.
Report failed.
I'm sure there's different fish available in here. Past.
Unknown.
Gas cylinder.
Hypothesis. Garbage.
Garbage.
Complete.
B2B, I've been thinking about something.
What?
Do you think this fellow is being a little too...
this...
I don't know, glorified?
That's certainly one way to put it.
Pascal's place, right? Yeah, it is. Yeah, there's potentially like secrets for the next run. Yeah, let's try giving more money to the halfwit vetted. I think I have 100,000 G's. But I think that's gonna be the last one. So how much more do I need? A lot. 75,000 more G's. To sustain that amount of money. But I did get two or three of those machine cores, and maybe I can sell those and have enough. Let's check. Since I am trying to blah 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 blah. This is cures all status elements. I don't think I've dealt with any status elements ever. I remember. But it seems it's worthless. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna need it though for a weapon. I did too much, oh well. It's not that rare. Black part. Wow, look at all those rare materials I'm not gonna use. Thick dictionary. So I researched about these machine cores and say there's really nothing that they're used for. Pretty fun, I'd say. Barely. Some good mistakes. I think we should just leave again. I started to like this one girl. I thought I was gonna short circuit whatever. Yeah. Reminds me of Sora no Tsuchimono. Called Heaven's Lost Property, the anime. Pretty much it's like based off of Angeloids, which are like angels and android bodies. But they're like, one of them pretty much didn't have any emotions programmed into it. And over time, she like learns love, I guess. Or like develops what that feeling would be. And she'd always say that her reactor hurts, which pretty much meant her heart. That reminds me of this, what's going on here. Probably passionate. I'll not waste words on your junk. So I guess I have to return to the thing still. I have enough money now. I can go back to her. Something. What is that? Seems to be inside the auditorium. Theater. That's in the forest, I believe, which I can't get to. That's also. I think I can't get there either. No, it's in the abandoned factory. I can get there, actually. To go all the way back there. That sucks. So let's talk to this wandering couple. Let's go back to the park. This is the final mount I need, so piece by piece I've been giving up money to get to 100k, and now he wants 100k again, straight. The time has come. The Great Invention! That reminds me of Claptrap. From Borderlands. Babe. Oh, damn. Did not reach the moon. Landed on Mars. Still, all is not lost. I'll go and sell you some of the materials a rocket carried back from that red distillate plant. Oh shit. Buy some of these, actually. Pretty sure they use it for, crafting? Keep doing that. Alright, back to Rooster Park. I wasn't even sure if I can go this way. I can just run here and hope for the best. So I think I'm first gonna go to the abandoned factory, because it's a quick battle I can do. Should probably save too, actually. Should be a safe place right before the factory area. There's actually a safe place in that alleyway. That save, and go to the factory. Now I wonder if the Father Salvo, the martial art guy, keeps telling us to get him more stuff so he can upgrade himself to fight us later.
How high the level goes?
Because it seems to be going up by 10 every time we fight him. I know I probably can't do some of the fights. At least not head on. I guess I can just keep hacking him. Exactly where it's supposed to be. I mean, if I can't access him, then definitely do this later. He's outside. Which would make sense. Be this way, so can't get to him right now. I'm back where I've been before. Yeah. Let's see. He's actually above. Above me. It's on this level somewhere. Circle. The only bad thing when the level design is good around. Especially when the level looks very familiar to itself. Seems to be showing something. I think that's the I think I can turn in. So I do want to complete all the side quests this time around, if possible. But we'll see if I can or not. the big long trek to the desert again. Yeah, that's what I was talking about with these fetch missions. There's really no reason for me to have to go back to the dude that started the quest. Unless he actually gives me something, because the girl didn't give me anything, but I did do hers last playthrough, so maybe it didn't carry over the rewards. Last thing though, if it's available, then it should give it to me, the rewards associated with the quest. Otherwise, why give it, right? And that's why some of the quests don't open up again in subsequent playthroughs, if you've done it already. But yeah, in the story, I'm pretty much at the point right before the massive attack happens. And it was like a troll situation, because if you go the wrong way to get to the resistance camp, they game you over, like, for no reason. And that's, like, super dumb. Okay, let me try to get to this person real quick. Okay, so I can go straight, take me here, and then maybe take a left, we'll see. Maybe I have to go this way. Go straight. So many chips I need to fuse together. It kind of sucks you can't come back the way you came. I wonder if that's for story purposes. Because that shortcut we unlock only happens after you escape the first humanoid machine fight. And even then, I don't think they actually told us why the machines made a human. Or like, humanoid machine. Maybe I just missed it, I don't know. But I do know they've pretty much adopted a lot of human psychology. Because the story says Earth's been deserted for about a millennia, so the machines pretty much took over. Call it useless piece of junk. I wonder if people or these machines like Jean-Paul because...
This is exhausting. He doesn't care at all about anyone but himself. And yet his followers just keep talking about how great he is. What's the point of all this? And what's he even getting out of it?
Maybe you should ask him.
But I was going to say, the reason why the robots love Jean-Paul because they make him feel some sort of way. While, you know, machines generally don't have emotions at all. It's not in their programming, but over time they've gained sentience of some sort. So normally that would be the way out, but I can't get back up there. So I believe this is the other way out.
cleared.
Time to get out. See what other side quests I can do before I push the story forward. Don't know if I can get to the forest area yet. That place is locked out until some story events transpire. It's pretty much right when you get waypoints. That's technically half the game, I believe, half the story. The inventor's moon shuttle thingamabob. Guess I can turn on some tunes. It's pretty quiet. This is where I was gonna go. I think if I can get to the forest, I might be able to do something. Oh, there's something there. Question is, how do I... Well, that's through the ocean, isn't it? Yeah, that's the flooded city. I don't think I can get there. Alright, so one more run into Pascal's village. And then I'm gonna loop around into the amusement park, and then I'm gonna do the story. Let me see if there's a way I can, just make myself faster, pretty much. All this movement speed I could be having. Purposes. I'm not sure if this is the fastest I can be, but it definitely helps if it is. It's more than the previous chip loadout. Feels like it's faster. Might just be me. Being biased. Seems to be some path over there. Maybe that's the way to the forest. If I have excess amounts, see how a titanium alloy needs 3. So pretty much, if another item needed or another weapon needed a titanium alloy, I could do another one too. Find himself or something. Or play left letter for you here. Huh.
Well, he's nothing if not consistent. A weirdo right to the very end. I wonder if all his followers being female had something to do with his weirdness. Did the human sexes interact with each other like this?
Who knows?
Kinda, yeah. Playing hard to get / rejecting people. You can talk to the girl he liked, but yesterday he had some sort of relapse. Right, let's help you out. Uh-oh. Your deal. I've been trying, okay? I went out and talked to everyone I saw. I even talked to the girl I liked. It was fun. But then it got hard because you can't just talk to people, you know? You have to read between the lines and stuff. True. A lot of people don't like to be open book. Same size way easier. True that. True that. But I have a dream now. I'm gonna be the best shut-in I could possibly be. Next time I'm gonna make a lock you won't break into in bajillion quintillion years. I believe there's a mission inside the theater. I think I've done it before too. Maybe I did, I don't know, we'll see. Seems a lot faster. Zooming. safe?
It could be.
Yeah, it is. Kind of like, where's everybody? They're underneath. Exactly what I call fun game creator machines. Point, it's more like an unamused part. Yeah, just get everyone to play point on materials. Sure. Single tricolor cable. Gonna make a video game console. Riff enough. Thanks for the follow. I appreciate it. Are you enjoying everything? Yeah, right now I'm going through my second playthrough. Here. As you can tell, I'm playing as 9S instead of 2B. Have you, played this game or beaten this game? But yeah, I'm just going around doing side quests that I've missed the first time around. I've heard of the game but never played it before. And yeah, I heard there was actually, more of these games, so this is not the first one. I thought this was the first one, actually. But yeah, I think there's other ones. But it's been pretty good. Pretty interesting, because I don't want to spoil anything if you're going to play it. So I feel like it's pretty much a commentary on AI. And potentially them achieving sentience. If you want to know more, I can fill you in, but I don't want to spoil anything if you decide to play it. Yeah, Square Enix definitely knows how to make, how to publish the open world. I feel like it's a mix between multiple different styles of games. I don't really do it justice right now because I keep doing all the side quests, but there are points in the game where you pilot flight units, and that kind of turns into a different mode entirely. But I guess the main portion of the game is right here, the acronym flashing. Really beautiful game in terms of presentation, even the concept. We're technically robots too, and then we're facing off against machines, which are what the aliens used when they first invaded Earth about 1,000 years ago. And the humans created, well, they had to run away and escape to the moon. From there, they developed these androids, as you see here, 2B over there, and I'm playing as 9S. B stands for battle bot, I suppose. And then S stands for support unit. So they pretty much, if anything, also they're giving another commentary on, I guess, God. He created humans in his image, as the scriptures say. And so they kind of like bring that same thing here. Like these androids are created in the image of humans. But, yeah, we're just trying to re-inhabit Earth. I agree, the aesthetic of this game is cool, yes. Square Enix definitely, like, always delivered in the graphics department. I'm sure you've played, or at least seen, and or heard of other Square Enix titles. Chiefly, probably the Final Fantasy series. That's definitely, like, the best. In terms of, like, CGI graphics. Especially early on in the gaming industry. Our first Final Fantasy was 10. If anything, that was probably my first RPG, other than, you know, good old NES and N64 games, but my first, like, big boy game, Final Fantasy X. Shooting game, I have a feeling it's really buggy. Let's try this guy's game out. So, this is another element of the game, hacking. I'm gonna shoot all these like grayish nodes. Oh, and shoot back at you from drone. And then the target is that circle in the middle. Right now it's a force field because all these grays are still alive, but now that I shot them all, I can now attack it directly. There you go. Did you enjoy yourself? Oh, is that it? Is that different levels? I don't know if you can really see the arrow, it's very faint, but you only get 3 shots, or 3 hits before you lose. Maybe I just have to come back, I don't know. Let's try one more time. I want to just like get a place anytime. Serious to push like game forward. I'm assuming you just make it harder. I suppose, yeah, I know. I'd say that was the hardest one I've played so far, because they have many different hacking mini games and like enemy assortments. But yeah, it's pretty interesting. So that's another like little mini game they added into this. If I get far enough, you can see the other types. Have you heard of the Dark Souls and or Bloodborne series? I feel like they have weapons similar to that, at least the crafting system, where they have different weapon archetypes, and then you just upgrade them to make them stronger. Classmates have it in their Steam library. That was kind of the first Souls game I played for Bloodborne. Only because my friend was hyped about it, so I ended up actually getting a PS4 so I can play it. Because at the time I didn't really upgrade to the next gen yet, I was still playing
Xbox 360. I figured it was time to get the next gen console.
I chose PS4. Maybe because, again, the thing.
Xbox One didn't have too many exclusive titles that were worth getting. So might as well get the PS4. So I did. It also doesn't help that I have a gaming PC. So, you know, Microsoft is Windows, so they made it so a lot of the games that are exclusives could be bought on the Windows 10 Live Marketplace and then play it. So, turn up my volume on my microphone a little bit. So, let me actually turn down my music and then I can adjust some of this. See if that helps a little bit. Yeah, next stop is the resistance camp. And I'm still trying to figure out if people in the resistance camp are just more androids, or if they're actually humans. I think they're actually more androids. So they look like humans. But again, we all look like humans. All these androids. Also, the gameplay is pretty easy as well, because you can dodge pretty much in between anything you do, which is really few actions that aren't dodge-cancelable. So that's why they have on very hard, you actually only can take one hit, regardless, and you die. So in my mind, I'm like, that's not fun at all. But I guess if you play a lot of this game and you want more of a challenge, then they added that for you. Let me see here. Let's talk to this person. Bending balls like you can handle pretty much anything. And I've heard there are multiple endings to this game. Up to 4, I think. I can't really tell if I got the very good ending last time around. Felt pretty good. Nobody died. Granted, they're, again, all androids, and so their consciousness can be uploaded to, like, some main server, and they just would need a new body, right? Just download consciousness. And that's actually a premise in a different Netflix show called Alter Carbon. I don't know if you heard of that. I've watched only a couple of episodes, but same idea. You die, you just upload your body, or your consciousness to a different body. I still can't upgrade this. And here is the chip. Kind of mechanic they have, because we're robots, so we just install these chips to increase our parameters. And I feel like this chip fusing thing is kind of modeled off of mobile games, because you have two of the same ones, you can fuse them together to create a stronger version. As you can see, I need to watch my money. Kind of just doing this like automatically, because you really don't need money other than these chips and also upgrading. As we said, Black Mirror San Junipero or Juperino episode has a similar content as well with uploading your mind to a computer. Yeah, I feel like that's like the next step potentially in technological development, other than like just straight up AI. Which is also on Netflix, in case you're ever bored. I feel like I stream too much. So, like, the free time I do have, I'm streaming instead of watching Netflix. Which is good or bad, I can't really tell. It's, like, the same thing. I do this leisurely to, like, wind down. Granted, Sundays I can do this a little earlier, but most days if I'm not playing volleyball, I'm streaming. And then I work normal job during the day. Definitely I can look that one up. I'd at least add it to my to watch list. Wow. If you can see the little numbers in the brackets, that tells you how much space it uses up, how much memory space it uses up. So, it's also cool how they did that as well. Let me see this. I don't really care about that. Combust. Okay, this is a lot of the 9S chips. I'm running out of monies. Some of these items are used to strengthen your weapon, but some of them are strictly used to sell for money, but some of them I'm not 100% sure, so I've been hoarding a lot of them. I feel like a lot of these, like, they say they're exchanged for money, but I don't know if they could also be used for other things, so I'm just holding on to them. I really need to research, like, what's worth keeping and what's okay to sell. Yeah, so if I look at the chip system. So you have this like big old, I don't know what you want to call that, but that pretty much tells you how much memory space you have, and then you can plug in these chips, and each chip takes a different like chunk of space. And so depending on, again, what you use, you gain or lose different abilities. I feel like I should put these two on, actually. Yeah, let me take off some of these. This one's pretty invaluable. Every time you kill something, you regain 40% of your health. This one I don't think I need. Voice stagger after hits if HP is 60% more. Actually, maybe I do. Reduce damage. Oh, do I have no support skills? Do I have hacking? Strength three mobility control. So I pretty much never use that, so let's not have that on. Some movement speed. So it says I have 4 more storage free to use. And then we have these system chips, which I thought pretty interesting. Like this one, a OS chip. So pretty much if I remove this, I die. So automatically you have to use 2 space just to stay functional. And some of these other stuff is just for, you know, if you want more intel on what you can do in the world. Like for this, like, you don't necessarily need it, right? How much damage you're doing. If anything, I should probably take that off, because it doesn't help me any. Are you actually able to remove the OS chip? I can try it, so let me just go save. Then I can try it, see what happens. They're pretty funny. Because the only penalty you have when you die is that you... So like in Dark Souls, you drop all of your chips in this game where your body is. Because, again, your consciousness gets put into a new body. And so all the chips you had in your previous setup, you know, get dropped with your body. So I'm just going to activate that... third chipset that has pretty much nothing in it except for the basics, and yeah, we'll see. I'm gonna double save just in case. Let's see what happens when I remove it. So it becomes a shits and giggles right here. Alright. I feel like my body just drops dead at that spot. And then you just respawn somewhere. And we can't move. But OS will result in death. Oh, it's the ending credits. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. So that's another troll ending. If you remove your OS chip. Though again, it's funny because, like, sometimes you just die, so why do that? Oh, it's sent me to the main menu. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. So my hypothesis was incorrect. I thought I would just die and be put into a new body from the, what should I call it? They look like vending machines to me. I don't know what you think they look like, but you just pop out of a vending machine. Be a good call on that to see. So yeah, you come out of these vending machines with a new body. So normally, when you did die, you just leave a corpse, and then you had to go back to your corpse to retrieve all your chips. But yeah. That is what happens when you remove the OS. Let's see. So I still have 10 chips available. Or chip slots, I should say. It's not enough space. I only have 10. Maybe 9, I guess. 8% plus 10, 20. Yeah, that's fine. Actually, make sure I have my speed boost on. Yeah. Nothing better than, like, running really fast. Especially when you have to traverse long distances. Now, this is before I unlocked the ability to fast travel places. I don't know why they wait so long for you to unlock that. Because you should be able to fast travel between these two, right? But all I have is one waypoint. Because I haven't gotten far enough into the story. Alright, let's see here. Something back here I can look at. Whoop. Already open. Probably has already finished that manager's mission from the previous story run. Three numbers. The one cool thing is the different camera angles that you get. So here we get like this 2D side-scroller camera angle. Then once we get out here, we go back to the normal, like, 3D camera angles. Alright, so finally I can continue the story. So Pascal's the leader of the machine village I was previously at before, I think we first got, or we first followed, actually. There are supposed to be enemies, the resistance and machines, but the machine village that we came from is actually like a safe haven for machines that have been taken off the network. So
friendly because they're not, like, given kill orders, right? So they're just pretty much trying to live peacefully. You know, they're robots. Because, again, they don't have any real purpose. Because originally their purpose was to kill the humans, but all the humans have been gone for, like, 1,000 years, more or less. And so, it's like, what do you do now, right? As a robot.
What do you think?
And that's Pascal.
He just started transmitting to us directly.
Now do you believe we're not a threat?
Your mouth can say anything it wants, but you still don't have a heart.
I suppose that's technically accurate. Yes, well, you're free to visit our village whenever you like.
Pretty cool that the currency is pretty much these, like, nuts and bolts. There are some machine parts. I keep wanting to call it gold, but I know it's not gold. I mean, some of these enemies have, like, metal plates that you can't shoot through. You have to knock them off. But they come up pretty quickly, so it's not that big of a deal. Is that the way to the... No, I don't think so. That's the way to the amusement park. I want to get to Machine Village. Collectible. I sometimes wonder, like, if some of the development team for other games from Square Enix made this as well, or, like, worked on this one as well. Because there definitely are some bleed over, like, game mechanics. Because I definitely have vibes of Final Fantasy 15 in this game. I don't think they actually came out close to each other. I think they both came out in 2017, I believe. So I'm not sure. Oh, down there. So yeah, this is like a broken down version of the vending machine. So that's pretty funny. I would like a TV, please. All androids and machines can live together in peace like this.
After all, the only way to understand someone is to get to know them. Isn't that right?
Fair enough.
Alright. So here's technically another troll ending.
Operator to 9S. Emergency transmission incoming. We've detected a Goliath-class enemy inside the city ruins. It seems to be accompanied by a large number of machine life forms. All Yorha members are ordered to engage at once.
But Goliath? This was a trap. I knew it!
I promise you,
9S is very,
we were not
skeptical
aware
of these
this information.
Machines.
Kind
of
I realize
whatever.
The odds
like,
of you believing me
things.
Are strikingly low, but I hope you will nonetheless.
We'll sort it out later. Let's go.
That's Avian. So for fun, I can just show the troll ending again, because this is the way to the. Oh, this is the way to the amusement park.
Confirm current destination.
So I go too far, I actually game over.
The operational area
see?
Has resulted in significant allied casualties.
So I'm not gonna do that. It's kind of a waste of time. But if you keep going that way, they just end the game and
proposal.
Get game over screen again.
Confirm current destination.
So gotta go this way back to. The Resistance City. No, I think we just get to like the main area and then they already start the attacking sequence. Yep.
Operator 210 here. Do you read me? Operator to 9S. I have bad news and I have good news. Bad first. We've confirmed the presence of two Goliath-class heavy weapon enemies.
Two of them?
Now
two
the good news. We've used your previous Goliath combat data to analyze the enemy, and it seems we have identified a weakness. Command has modified a firing unit based on this new intel. It's been installed on a pair of flight units that are heading your way.
That's your R&D for you.
Check your map data. Operator out.
Thanks, Operator. 2B, Command is deploying new flight units for us. They just set the coordinates, so let's get going.
On it.
Alright, so we're about to, fight with the Goliath, and I'm not sure if they're gonna do it right away, but flight units have a new kind of game mode. So you kind of start off the game that quick, but periodically you use the flight module. Like, I think they're dropping mortar shells on them.
The flight units should be on the roof of that building up ahead. It'll be dangerous, but we're not going anywhere unless we pass through that Goliath's legs. We should be careful.
That's the Goliath. So big that it's probably gonna see it running in here.
Those flight units, right. What we can.
So that's the first Goliath, I believe. I don't even know if it's killed all the way, actually, to be honest.
Enemy anti-air defenses are on patrol at higher altitudes. A low altitude approach is recommended.
Got it, thanks.
Right. What was in Gundam time?
Even this though, I can't make this different.
Target enemies offline. That should do it for the Goliaths.
Look out! It's recharging!
Recharging. Yep. Yes, it is still like part of the first third of the game. Story-wise.
Enemy vibrations are growing in intensity. It's resonating in tandem with the area beneath the combat zone.
Having fast travel since halfway. I don't know why they did that, but I guess just to slow the game down a little bit. There we go. So now the map's changed forever.
What the?
Unbelievable. The aliens who haven't revealed themselves in hundreds of years.
That's the commander.
Were hiding underground?
So with that, it unlocks a lot of side quests. Some of them I can't do because I've done them already. But it's pretty much the ones that have, like, I say, like, big rewards. Whether it be like accessories.
This is your commander. Like, for the first time in centuries, we've intercepted a signal belonging to the aliens. These are the creatures that are in direct command of the machine life forms on this planet. If we can destroy them, we can end this long and arduous war once and for all. Our intel team is hard at work attempting to analyze the source of the signal, but we're not there yet. We need more data. All Yorha units are hereby ordered to prioritize data collection above all else. We can't let this chance slip through our fingers. Glory to mankind.
I used Command's data to determine the signal's source and marked it on the map. But it seems to be underground. Like, way underground.
Guess we'll see once we get there. If we're lucky.
You're not much for plans, are you, 2B?
So now the I don't know if I like that better. A lot of RPGs, they reveal new areas for you to explore, and that's when you encounter stronger enemies. But here, you pretty much progress through the story, and then things kind of automatically get stronger. I think it also scales with your level too. I mean, if you don't progress the story, the enemies still sort of progress with you, level-wise. Fine with it, but it's not what I'm used to. Yeah, it should be.
What is this?
Announces. It is a cave-in caused by the collapse of an open space underground.
Why is there such a huge cavern beneath the city?
This mission. This is a mission right here where I have to pretty much escort this parade of robots. Oh, the enemy's nearby, so I can't talk to him. I'm gonna go sleep. It's 12:30 for me. Till next time. Alright, man. Thanks for following again. Hope you have a good night. Hope I see you in the future. It's kind of a big Monday, I guess. Yeah, thanks again. Let's see if we can actually do this part. This is ridiculous. Try to do this. So I think they're made to be super tanky.
Exiting the planned operational
but
area.
I am chipped up. Walking the floor with these guys. I feel like this mission also might be level kind of.
Did level bow? Because they're very, they used to be very tanky and strong, but that was my first playthrough when I was low level. But now they're no match for me. I think what was also cool is that the chips work for both you and your partner. So, however strong you are, 2B is also strong. They have parade. So slow. Last one's gonna kill everybody. Kind of close, actually. I thought it would have been a lot easier than that, but we managed to complete the break without being annihilated. Please accept. That's pretty good reward right there. All right. Do you think this fools? Nah, not really. Just another quest to do. What we got over here. Was it the same rebuild this guy quest? Oh, it looks like a new parade's available. Yeah, just need four screws.
Target location data obtained. Marking on map.
Did you learn anything from the factory data?
Just how it was manufactured. Pretty boring, actually.
There's still a lot about machines that we don't understand. Gather as much data as you can, no matter how irrelevant it may seem. We know we can find pristine screws on big bipedal machines, but what about large gears?
Let's try the operator again. 9S to operator. We're trying to track down a large gear. Any idea where to start the search?
Why are you looking for... Well, anyway... You can salvage the requested material from smaller machine lifeforms. Finding one intact might prove tricky, however. The part is easily damaged when the machine housing it is destroyed.
Thanks, operator. That's good to know.
Right. Let's go take out some small fry.
to offer. Straight to the point, as always, 2B.
So plug-in chips, classify data. Gotta help me get them back. Do plug-in chips. Alright.
Alert. Signal code detected for missing plug-in chip. Marking approximate location on map.
Requested
plug-in chip obtained.
Oh, I hate that. Not at night, but at least take a break and eat.
That's a weird looking enemy.
I don't even know how I dodged that. I wonder if that feels like a little white cube right there. I wonder if that's a, what you call it? Ouch. I'm gonna drink that. I feel like increasing the time to get through the attack. The robot I subjugated as Halo rather. Detonating.
Christina's crew. I'm doing this. Let's get out of this little bad spot. I hate those screw monsters. Or worms. Let's get that guy. There must be something above. I don't know if I can get that from here, though. There must be something below. Oh, this is the underground. I don't know if it's the same one though. Yes it is. That treasure chest is already over there. Or maybe I'm just taking that one. Just a second. This might take me elsewhere. This takes me to the water. I think there's a couple side quests out here, so at least I'm clean out. This guy aggravated. I wonder if it's because I have the sensor pouch that it won't attack me at all. That'll be interesting. Ooh, gold ore. Oh, yes, for the ninja guy. Wandering couple. Yes, you are. No, you're not. There you are. Oh. I think he's alive this guy. Cocked him. It's the wandering couple again. Foolish man. Not enough.
There's
cash.
Another of those machines.
Strange.
I suppose it's going to attack me, right?
This machine type purposely seeks out androids in order to enact revenge. It should be dispatched immediately.
Got it.
Oh yeah, those little guys have really strong. There's like super strong. Wow. Good new attack pattern actually. Previously when I was
I don't have the strength to continue.
to avenge their families? That's absurd.
Oh, man, data shows that humans often engaged in similar activities throughout mankind's history. Such attempts at revenge were often seen as justified.
And yet, I...
Nice.
Anything else out here? I see money. I don't know if I have 50k yet. I didn't close. I didn't sell stuff. Okay. Let me go ahead and save. Dinner slash break. I'll be back in like 30 minutes, maybe an hour. Oh, that's a moose.